Just about every modern application needs a way to email people from your app. That's where Resend comes in. I'm going to show you how to use Create and Resend together. Today, we're going to look at setting up a custom domain with Resend, then integrating that into Create so that we can send emails to contacts on our list. You ready? Let's go. You can see here I've got an application started with Create. It's just a simple contact app where I can add new contacts. So let's say I come in here and say something like Nicole, and then I'll send this to myself, but I'll use a plus email address so I can just kind of send it all to the same place. We'll do plus Nicole at resend.com. Okay, so once I create the contact, you'll see that it is added down this way. And now I can come in here and edit it if I want to, delete it, or eventually send an email. Now we've yet to set anything up with Resend, so that's the first thing I want to do. Let's jump into the Resend account and add my custom domain. Okay, so I've created a free Resend account and I've gone to the domains tab right here, and I'll need to add my own custom domain if I want to send to anyone other than myself. Let's click add domain, and here I need to add the domain I have. Now I happen to have resend-createxyz.com. Now you'll notice here in the recommended section, it suggests using a subdomain. This essentially kind of gates your reputation per type of email you send. So if you were doing a more production grade application, I would encourage you to do that. In this case, this should be just fine, and I can choose any of these regions. You want to pick whatever region will be closest to your users. Let's just say that I'm mostly US based, so I'll do that. Once you click add domain, you will need to add some DNS records to authorize Resend to send on your behalf. Now I've purchased this domain using Cloudflare, so it's especially easy for me, but if you're not using Cloudflare, you can manually do the exact same thing we're going to do. You just need to add these records right here. It's also helpful to add a DMARC, and if you're interested more in that, we've got details here in our docs as well if you want to click inside here and check any of these out. Okay, but that being said, I'm using Cloudflare and I've got kind of a quick start with Cloudflare. So if I click sign into Cloudflare, it's going to actually check that I own this domain, then add all those keys for me. I will simply click authorize, and then it will go through the process of authorizing my domain. Now, DNS propagation can take some time, but once you add those records successfully and mark that you've done so, Resend will check until it verifies your domain. That took just about 2 minutes for it to verify, and now it's showing everything is verified. Now, what that means is I can send from anywhere at resend-createxyz.com using Resend. So we've done the core of what we need to do in Resend, that is to make sure we have our own custom domain. You only have to ever do that once. Now let's integrate this into our app. Okay, back in the app here, you can see that for any contact, I can click send email, and then I can add a subject and a message and click send. Now right now this does nothing because we haven't hooked anything up. So that's what I want to do next. So if I come over here, I can just simply say whenever I send my email, send the email using, and then I'll do the forward slash and simply grab Resend from the list. This official integration with Resend means you get all the power of Resend without having to read all of our docs. Create takes care of all that for you. So you can see here it's created a function for handling sending the emails and then updated our actual page to use it. Now, if it doesn't show you an input here for adding your API key, you can add it by coming up top here and clicking secrets and add it directly in here. Now, this was called Resend API key. Now, if you're not used to handling API keys, you need to handle them very sensitively. And that's because they basically give access to everything within your account. So what we're going to do next is grab a Resend API key and then paste it in this input field. So I'm back in my Resend dashboard and I've clicked on API keys. Now let's go ahead and create a new API key. And right now I'm just going to call this something like demo. You can name it whatever you want. It's just an identifier for you to know. Now you can set full access or only sending access. I'll just keep it at full access in all domains since I only have one and click add. Now, importantly, you can only see this once. So you want to copy it right here and you're going to store it in your project. So back in my project, I'm going to simply paste it directly in here. And now everything should be up to date. In fact, let's go back to the chat just to verify what we've got over here. And I'll click Chris over here. We'll send an email. I should be able to say something like hi, and let's send a message. Now, once I do this, I'll click send and it should be send the email successfully. Now it says it's done that. Let's just go ahead and check that that's the case. Now we don't have to take our application's word for it. We can actually verify that this email has sent. First, we'll look at the Resend dashboard, and secondly, I'll look in my email. Okay, so here in the Resend dashboard, you'll notice under emails, it shows everything I've sent by my email. If I click inside here, not only will I get access to everything, like what I've sent, the plain text, the HTML, and even some insights into some best practices with sending, but you'll see that I actually see who it's from and who it goes to. Now notice something here, it's sent from at resend.dev, not my own custom domain. And that's because that's the last thing we need to do, which is to tell the application that we're building to use my custom domain instead of this default onboarding one. I mentioned we can also check it in our email inbox. And if I come over here, you'll see that that's exactly what's happened. It's sent directly to me. So the last thing to do is to update our function to make sure we're using our custom domain. This will ensure you can send it to anybody, not just your own account like I have right here. We can update the sending domain in a few different ways. Of course, I could simply ask the chat, or if you want to, you can come up here, and if you're a little bit more familiar with code, you can say, hey, let's check the actual resend API function that's going to be sending the email. Now to see the code, I have to click on this little code button over here, and there's the culprit right here. So if I don't pass in a from, it will send it from onboarding@resend.dev. So now that you've seen where to change it in the code, let's just change it via chat in case you're more familiar with that. So I'll just tell it to make sure it sends the emails from my custom domain, and I'll assign the inbox chris@resend-createxyz.com. Now you can also tell resend to reply to a certain address, so you may want to send it from one and have them reply to another, but for now I'll just keep it real simple. And notice it's going to update the API function call, and in fact, again, I can jump over here to the code and see that that's exactly what it's done. Now once it finishes building and updates, I should be able to send to any email address I want using my custom domain. Again, if you're just onboarding with resend, you can only send to yourself, but once you add your own custom domain, you can send to any email address. Okay, so I'm all prepped and ready to send this to Nicole. I can just come over here and click send, and now it should use my custom domain. Now, since I happen to be using an alias for my own Gmail account, we're gonna see it in the Gmail account as well. But let's check those two places again, the resend dashboard and also Gmail. Okay, so in my resend dashboard, I can see right over here that I've sent it from Chris, and notice it comes from my own custom domain, and I've sent it to somebody else. Now I can see the email in my own inbox sent from my custom domain. Now, obviously there's way more you'd want to do with this application, like make the email actually look good and maybe log it in the application as well. But hopefully this gets you started with using resend. We've set up our own custom domain, added resend to our create project, and then customized the call to use that custom domain that we added. Thanks so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Happy coding.